Espíritu Santo.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Gathered as one, let us now give glory to our God.
To Moses and Aaron.
From now on, this month will be the first month of the year for you. Announce to the whole community of Israel that on the 10th day of this month, each family must choose a lamb or a young goat for a sacrifice, one animal for each household. If a family is too small to eat a whole animal, let them share with one another, with another family in the neighborhood. Divide the animal according to the size of each family and how much they can eat. The animal you select must be a one-year-old male, either a sheep or a goat, with no defects. Take special care of this chosen animal until the evening of the 14th day of this first month. Then the whole assembly of the community of Israel must slaughter their lamb or young goat at twilight. They are to take some of the blood and smear it on the sides and top of the door frames of the houses where they eat the animal. That same night, they must eat it along with bitter salad greens and bread made without yeast. These are your instructions for eating this meal. Be fully dressed, carry your walking stick in your hand. Eat the meal with urgency, for this is the Lord's Passover. On that night, I will pass through the land of Egypt and strike down every firstborn son and firstborn male animal in the land of Egypt. I will execute judgment against all the gods of Egypt, for I am the Lord. But the blood on your doorposts will serve as a sign, marking the houses where you are staying. When I see the blood, I will of death will not touch you when I strike the land of Egypt. This is a day to remember. Each year, from generation to generation, you must celebrate it as a special festival to the Lord. This is a law for all time. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Nuestra respuesta del Salmo de hoy. Va a ser en español. Nuestra respuesta es: ojalá escuchen hoy la voz del Señor, no endurezcan el corazón.
Lectura de la carta de San Pablo a los Corintios. Yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les transmití a ustedes, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que fue traicionado, tomó pan. Después de dar gracias, lo partió y dijo: este pan es mi cuerpo, que por ustedes entrego. Hagan esto en memoria de mí. Jesús, después de cenar, tomó la copa y dijo: esta copa es el nuevo pacto en mi sangre. Hagan esto cada vez que beban de ella en memoria de mí. Porque cada vez que comen este pan, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que Él venga. Palabra de Dios.
Y no solo los pies, sino también las manos y la cabeza.
El que ya se ha bañado no necesita lavarse más que los pies, le contestó Jesús. Pues ya todo su cuerpo está limpio, y ustedes ya están limpios, aunque no todos. Jesús sabía quién lo iba a traicionar, y por eso dijo que no todos estaban limpios. Cuando terminó de lavarles los pies, se puso el manto y volvió a su lugar. Entonces les dijo, ¿entienden lo que he hecho con ustedes? Ustedes me llaman maestro y señor, y dicen bien porque lo soy. Pues si yo, el señor, el maestro, les he lavado los pies, también ustedes deben lavarse los pies los unos a los otros. Les he puesto el ejemplo para que hagan lo mismo que yo he hecho con ustedes. Palabra del Señor.
Gloria a ti, Señor.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
Before the Passover celebration, Jesus knew that his hour had come to leave this world and return to his Father. He had loved his disciples during his ministry on earth, and now he loved them to the very end. It was time for supper, and the devil had already prompted Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him authority over everything, and that he had come from God and would return to God. So he got up from the table, took off his robe, wrapped a towel around his waist, and poured water into a basin. Then he began to wash the disciples' feet, drying them with the towel he had around him. When Jesus came to Simon Peter, Peter said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You don't understand now what I am doing, but someday you will." "No," Peter protested, "you will never, ever wash my feet." Jesus replied, "Unless I wash you, you won't belong to me." Simon Peter exclaimed, "Then wash my hands and head as well, Lord, not just my feet." Jesus replied, "A person who has bathed all over does not need to wash except for the feet to be entirely clean. And you disciples are for Jesus knew who would betray him." That is what he meant when he said, "Not all of you are clean." After washing their feet, he put on his robe again and sat down and asked, "Do you understand what I was doing? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, because that is what I am. And since I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash each other's feet. I have given you an example to follow. Do as I have done." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It won't be too long. We have a lot to do this evening. But we are here to commemorate an event that took place long ago in a place far away from where we are at this moment. And yet, what we are celebrating tonight is relevant to us in this very moment or hour. But I want to make a suggestion to you at first. I want to suggest to you that everything is not as it appears. There's more to reality than we see with our eyes. There's something else behind the scenes, all the time, in every place. We are just unaware of this other reality. But as human beings, we live in two realities at the same time. We live in the visible world, the world of experience and sense, perception, time and space and matter. But simultaneously, we live in an invisible realm of the spirit. It is from this invisible realm, which is called the heavenly place, divine visitor in history, in the person of Jesus Christ. People who met this extraordinary man were utterly and completely amazed and astonished at him, and they were radically transformed. And they came to believe that this human person among them, this humble man, who seemed no different than any other, was really quite different. He was more than man. He was also something divine. This has been the faith of us as Christians for these centuries. But Jesus reveals to us the hidden world that we know is there and suspect is there, but we don't know for sure. For Jesus has torn the veil of intangibility that separates us from the real world, the world of endless day. We are just but a reflection of that world, and we live in a world that is quickly passing away. Everything is passing away. That's why we call it the temporal world. I see before me, even my own life is passing before me in my own, before my own eyes. I now have come to the realization that there's more life. So I become acutely aware of my mortality, and I become interested in knowing more about this invisible realm that Jesus reveals to us. You're probably wondering what this all has to do with what we're celebrating tonight. Well, it's simply this. We are here together to pray together. And to pray together in the company of someone who was raised from the dead, named Jesus of Nazareth. That is why we're here tonight, to pray together. Praying together is a deeply human experience. It's what all humans do. I've never met a person who's never prayed at any time in their life. Have you? Even the most hardened atheist, I will have to confess that there have been moments in his or her life where she broke down and offered a prayer for help. Something happens when we pray. And I think what happens when we pray is that our prayers penetrate the veil that separates us from the unseen world. And then our prayers become a conduit in which we bring the uncreated light of God and the grace of God and the Holy Spirit into this tangible world. Jesus has torn the veil. It's open. And the way he did this was he has given us a meal, because Jesus liked dinner parties. And the meal is called the Eucharist. And the Eucharist becomes the highest prayer of the Jesus people. And you know something? We are the people of Jesus. And he said he would always remain with us, and that we come into his presence and we receive his very life in this thing we call the Eucharist. This is what we're celebrating. When we receive the Eucharist, it transforms us. When we are transformed, we go out those doors and we transform the world. And when we transform the world, we give people hope. And when we give people hope, we set them free to love. That is why we're here. We're here to become loving and to learn how to love. It's the only thing we'll take with us from this life. All your riches, all your education, it all goes away. When I had a stroke, I lost my mind. I was living in a blank. I had no idea what was happening to me. And yet, somehow, I saw things that I didn't see before. I became aware of things that I was not aware of before. So there's more to life than what appears. And we're called to pray in order to bring heaven to earth. And the highest prayer to accomplish this is the Mass, the Eucharist. And we are celebrating the Last Supper of Jesus tonight in this space. It was done 2,000 years ago in a place called the Upper Room in Jerusalem, where there are about 120 disciples, not just the 12, that were there with Jesus celebrating the Passover. And the entire time during this great party and Passover, the disciples were doing something that we do here at St. Matthew's quite well. They were arguing with each other and fighting with each other. And what were they arguing over? Jesus was there celebrating the Passover. They were in the presence of Jesus Christ at table, and they were fighting with each other at the Passover. It's like fighting at Thanksgiving dinner or something like that. So they're having a fight, and Jesus asked them what they were talking about, and they were afraid to tell him. You know what they were thinking about, arguing with each other? Who among them was in charge? Who was the greatest among them? Isn't that what we do? We're always arguing with each other, promoting our own self-interest. When we are called to pray to bring heaven to earth, when we do that, we fulfill the call of Jesus upon our hearts, and we transform the world. That's what we celebrate tonight, and we will begin with the washing of the feet, because Jesus demonstrates to his disciples, as they were arguing who was going to be the greatest among them, I want you to follow my example. Wash each other's feet. We're doing that tonight. So I invite you, we're going to wash everybody's feet. Is that okay? Have you ever had that done before? So we have these two wooden pews up here, and they can hold about 6 people each. We will do it in shifts. So I would like 6 people sitting there, 6 there, and you just have to remove your socks and shoes. And guess what? Father Arturo is going to wash your feet. So let's do this. And as we do this, let us remember the lesson we are being taught by our Master. It's better to serve than to be served. And that, I think, is the gospel of the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, I didn't let you translate for me. Did you all understand what I said?
Yes.
Oh, good. We are now going to do the washing of the feet, and we invite you to come and sit in these wooden pews.
Vamos a seguir con el lavatorio de los pies, y los invitamos a todos a estar sentados en las bancas. El Padre Clemente me va a ayudar.
Thank you.
de dar la vida por sus amigos.
Señor, yo te
Oh.
gracias por participar. Ojalá que les gustaron que sus pies fueron lavados.
When Jesus finished washing the feet of his disciples,
cuando Jesús terminó lavar los pies de sus discípulos,
he went back and sat down at table.
Se sentó en la mesa.
This was in the upper room.
En el segundo
people were present.
Como 120 personas presentes.
As Jesus reclined at table,
cuando estaba sentado reclinado en la mesa,
every eye was fixed on him.
Todos los ojos estaban fijados a él.
You could hear a needle drop.
Pueden escuchar una aguja caer.
There was nothing but silence.
Solo había silencio.
They were stunned.
Eran maravillados.
And so they did not know what to say. Arguing about who was going to be the most important and who was going to have the final say.
Porque se estaban discutiendo quién era el más importante y quién manda.
And Jesus says, it's not to be that way with you.
Y Jesús dijo, no va a ser así con ustedes.
I show you another way.
Yo les voy a enseñar otro camino.
And the way of Jesus not only was meant for those people long ago,
y el camino de Jesús no es solo para los que estaban en su tiempo.
But Jesus is talking to you in this very moment.
Jesús les está hablando hoy, ahorita.
So, he says, don't be arguing about who is in charge.
Así que Jesús dijo, no estén discutiendo quién manda.
Follow my example.
Sigue mi ejemplo.
And serve everyone.
Y sirve a todos.
Because love serves everybody.
Porque el amor sirve a todos.
And Jesus then proceeded to say to his disciples, as the Father, my Father, has loved me, love you.
Y Jesús procedió diciendo, como el Padre me ama a mí, así también los amo yo a ustedes.
You must always remain in my love.
Y tienen que permanecerse siempre en mi amor.
If you keep my commandments,
si siguen mis mandamientos,
you will be able to love.
Podrán amar.
And my Father and
I, el Padre y yo, veremos a ustedes y los amaremos.
I am Master and Lord.
Soy el Maestro y Señor.
And this is true.
Porque es cierto.
As your master and Lord, you are not greater than me. If I serve, you must serve.
Como Señor y Salvador, como yo he lavado los pies y los he servido a ustedes, también los tienen que hacer lo mismo.
Jesus says, I did not come to be served.
Jesús dijo que no vine a ser servido.
But I have come to serve.
Sino vino a servir.
And to give my life.
Dar mi vida como expiación de todos.
You are my friends.
Ustedes son mis amigos.
If you observe what I instruct you to do.
Si hagan lo que yo les digo.
And this is my instruction.
Y esto es mi mandamiento.
You must love each other even as I have loved you.
Tienen que amarse unos a otros como yo los he amado.
And there's no greater love than this.
Y no hay amor más grande que esto.
Than for you to sacrifice your life for others.
Que ustedes entregan su vida para otros.
That's a big price.
Es un precio muy grande.
But that's what Jesus is asking of you.
Pero es lo que está diciendo Jesús a ustedes.
We will continue with the Mass. Did we do the sign of peace yet?
Not yet.
Oh, we'll do the sign of peace. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I give you peace. My peace I leave you. Look not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us offer each other a sign of our Lord's peace.
Dense fraternalmente la paz.
Peace.
present my gifts of bread and wine. The highest prayer of the church.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
child, God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept us as a sacrifice for the grace of the glory of His name, for our good and the good of all of us.
Loving God, accept these gifts we now offer unto you, taken from the earth and transformed by human hands into bread and wine for this table. By the power of your Holy Spirit, may these gifts be transformed into the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. And may those of us who receive these gifts tonight be transformed into His image. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
El Señor esté con vosotros.
Señor, con espíritu.
Lift up your hearts.
Lo que
tenemos levantado hacia el Señor.
Jesús, estoy necesario.
Father, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise. At the Last Supper, as he sat at table with his disciples, Jesus offered himself to you as the spotless lamb, the acceptable gift that gives you perfect praise. Christ has given to bring us its saving power until the end of all time. In this great sacrament, you have life that strengthens us in love and holiness, so that the human family may come to walk in the light of one faith in the one communion of love. We come then to this blessed sacrament to be fed at your table and to grow into the image of your Son, the risen Christ. Earth unites with heaven to sing the new song of creation as we adore and praise you forever.
This is my body, which will be given up for you.
When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said,
Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
Rising, you restore.
death and resurrection. We offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and to serve you. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in the unity of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love, together with all the church leaders, especially Bishop Peter, our own bishop. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence.
Happy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, John and Paul, with Moses, the prophet, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Because we live in the days of COVID, So we spray disinfectant on your hands. Then you come up and we will give you the host, communion. You all may come. And then when you receive the host, which is the little bread, which is the body of Christ, then you take it and you approach the one who's holding the cup, and there's wine in the cup. That's the blood of Christ. You dip your host, the body of Christ, into the wine, the blood of Christ, and then you consume it immediately. That's how we now receive communion in these days and in this time. So you're welcome to come, because in doing so, you're receiving the very life of Jesus into your life.
For those of you watching at home and unable to participate, we offer this prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar. I love you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
See you.
Yeah.
subir el crucifijo y agarran velas cuando salgan y vamos a ir a la procesión donde está el reposo.
Thank you.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be His chaste blood.
Blessed be
His
chaste blood.
Blessed be God in the Holy Sacrament.
Blessed be God in the Holy Sacrament.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Then going out, Jesus went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he arrived at the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not undergo the test." After withdrawing about a stone's throw from them and kneeling, he prayed, saying, "Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Still, not my will, but yours be done." And to strengthen him, an angel from heaven appeared to him. He was in such agony, and he prayed so fervently that his sweat became like drops of blood falling on the ground. When he rose from prayer and returned to his disciples, he found them sleeping from grief. He said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not undergo the test." My brothers and sisters, the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now I have the text. Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
His most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be the Great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy.
Blessed be her Holy and Immaculate
Conception. Saint Joseph, her most chaste
spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and his saints. Amen.
Blessed be God and his angels and his saints. Amen.
Stay with me. beginning of Egypt. Those are appointed 9 o'clock, 10.
Vamos a tener la vigilia al Santísimo, que es el huerto, de ahorita hasta mañana a las 12 de mediodía. Los que pueden quedar a la hora que prefieren están invitados.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, before the world has been.
Tonight we keep vigil and adoration of our Lord Jesus at this altar of repose. We do so knowing that tomorrow we will walk with him to Calvary. Tomorrow is Good Friday, Stations of the Cross at 12 noon, followed by the veneration of the cross.
Pueden estar en vigilia hasta las 12 de la mañana y después vamos a seguir con la Vía Crucis y la adoración del Santísimo a las 12 del mediodía. Dos horas de vigilia y pueden apuntar sus nombres.